Hello everyone, my name is Cookie Cutter Hero, and today we're going to be doing something similar but different. We're going to play an adventure game by the name of Cedric and the Revolution. It is a point-and-click adventure game in the style of classic Lucasarts games from 2005. The game is taken from different sources, so this is lack of time because this was created for a contest of some sorts, but so this is a fun little indie adventure game, and I quite like it. It's not too long, but it's enjoyable. So here you are with our main character, Cedric. Good morning, sir. You're all new and awesome, and apprentice has arrived.
Hi, Cedric.
So this is a smithy. Awesome. Would this be the anvil? Cool. Ah, the stove where the blacksmith makes his metal all melty. Fun. And, of course, the blacksmith himself. Ahoy there, master. I'm ready for action.
Listen.
Of course. Do continue.
I can't take you, shorty.
What?
You can't be my apprentice. I can't afford it anymore.
But you promised.
Look, I'm sorry, but because of the recent tax raises, I just can't afford an apprentice.
I think I'm going to cry.
Sorry, Sid.
I'll cry like a baby.
Well, if you work for free, you could still be my apprentice.
For free? Are you insane? Who'd do such a thing? Well, not me, that's for sure.
Never hear of an internship?
What a tragedy. Yes. A tragedy indeed. Damn the king and his stupid taxes. Oh, I have an idea.
An idea?
Yep, an idea. We'll round up a few guys, go to the castle, and demonstrate. You know, with big signs, burning barrels and whatnot. What do you think?
That's a good idea, Shorty.
Thank you.
With the current taxes, I only barely manage to pay for my expenses. It's not fun to live like that. So, yeah, let's go.
Yay! Alright. So we are Cedric. We are this tiny little elf man. And here is Victor, who was our big elf man. So, this is standard point-and-click adventure fare. If you've ever played an adventure game of any kind, like LucasArts classics like Day of the Tentacle and Maniac Mansion, this should all be very familiar for you. So, there's a couple of things we need here in Victor's blacksmith shop. Bellows are fine. We need bellows. I'm gonna borrow your bellows for a while, Victor.
Oh, okay.
Very nonchalant. He doesn't care. Alright, let's take a look at that stove, shall we? Hot! Yes, indeed. Some tools. I guess Victor uses those to form hot iron into the desired shape. Very astute of you. Cedric, now one of these things I need. Can I get it? Nah, some of those tools look pretty sharp and dangerous. Meh. Where's the... I need a hammer. Oh, there it is. I'm gonna take a look at the hammer. It's a small hammer. Victor's anvil. Judging from the dents and scratches, it must be pretty old. Probably is. Don't pick up the anvil, Cedric. Pick up the hammer. I now own a hammer.
No, you don't. I'll let you borrow it, though.
Oh, Victor. Let's take a look at Victor. It's my soon-to-be instructor, Victor Gibbons. He's a good friend of my parents. I've known him for years. Last year, he promised Mum that I could be his apprentice. And here we are now, in this economic crisis. It's actually quite a good plot, I think. Now, what's up here? Box of matches! Let's try and get them. Nothing can go wrong. Can't reach them. Dang. Being short isn't fun. No, I know it isn't. Let's talk to Victor. Hey, Victor!
Yeah?
What's have a chat with Victor, shall we? Why are you so much taller than me?
Everyone in my family is big.
My mom is pretty tall, too, but I'm still slightly short.
Slightly short? You're the shortest kid in town I know.
You're not cheering anyone up that way.
Being short has its advantages. The ladies will think you're younger than you really are.
That would only have a use for gramps like you.
Oh, burn. Sick burn.
What do you think of this place?
I like my home quite a lot. I really could have used a hand in here, but,
Don't worry, maybe our little demonstration will force the king to act.
Hopefully it will. That would be nice.
Yeah, it would. Let's get those matches. Could you get those matches up from that shelf?
Sure, shorty.
Wink. Now we have matches. Now, this game could move extremely fast, but it's an adventure game, and that's not the point. The point is to look around and explore everything and mess around with stuff and see what everything has to say. So that's how I'm gonna play it. Tough. It says Victor Gibbons, blacksmith. That's a good sign. If you want to play this game yourself, you can get it from origamihero.com for free. It's quite worth it, I think. It's an old stand of some kind. Nobody uses it. That's a shame. What are these, nails? A few old nails are sticking out of that old stand. Well, typical adventure game logic says that if it's not nailed down, we should probably pick it up. And in this case, it is sort of nailed down. But we can take him.
You're pretty handy with a hammer, shorty. You'd make a good apprentice.
Yeah. Thanks, Victor. I think we would. Let's get that fishing net.
What are you gonna do with that old smelly thing?
No idea, but I'm sure enlightenment will come to us soon.
Of course it will, Cedric.
If you say so, shorty. Cedric, has a lot of big ideas. he's a bit of a thinking man. A mastermind.
You know that refusing to pay taxes is a punishable crime.
But taxes just for unloading my cargo here? Traders will stop coming here. It's gonna ruin the town's economy. Your hair.
You see?
Well, anyway, pay up now. I don't want to discuss any longer.
Blah, 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 economy, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, prison, blah.
Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, taxes, blah, cargo, blabber.
It's good dialogue. I like it. Let's take a look at these crates. Someone's unloaded them there. Let's have a little chat with the tax collector.
We're in the middle of a conversation. Scram, shorty.
Oh, his hair went loose again. What about Captain Howard? Can we talk to him? Nope. Well, I would like to have a talk with Captain Howard. So, I think that you're a jerk, Mr. Tax Collector. Let's, see what we can do about that. Bellows, wig, wind, yes. My creativity knows no bounds.
Foosh.
Aha. I say, this thing flies even more elegant than seagulls. Oh, look. It somersaulted. Oh, now it landed on the water.
My hair.
Now it's sinking.
I'll be back later. For now, I need to go, shopping.
Whatever floats your boat.
Hey, kid. Better hold on to your cap, or the wind will blow it off. Nice bellows you're carrying there, by the way.
Oh, very sneaky, Cedric. Very subtle. You lucky, lucky punk.
Thanks for getting rid of him, kiddo. He started to get on my nerves.
Yeah, mine too. Well, we can have a chat with him. I know that my cursor is going to show up in this playthrough, by the way. There's nothing I can do about it. Just the way that I'm recording. And something about, I don't know, the game itself running in a window. It's weird. Whatever.
Ahoy there! What's up, kiddo?
What's up? What kind of captain would say that?
It's a good question.
I'd prefer an ahoy, I, or R with extra tongue rolling.
Oh, okay. Ahoy there, shorty.
Much better, thanks.
Very, very Lucasarts-style dialogue.
How's business, Captain?
Bad. Very bad. It's too expensive to do business in this town. They also confiscated my ship until I pay the taxes.
That's horrible.
That's not nice at all.
Yeah, Victor knows what I'm saying.
Aye.
Would you want to come to the castle and demonstrate with us?
Sounds like a good idea. However, I've lost my monocle. I'm blind as a bat without it. And it's a vital part of my overall appearance.
We'll see if we can find it.
Thank you.
What a stylish hat.
Pretty cool, huh? I nabbed it off of a sleeping pirate in the bar.
Nah. Cheeky. Alright, see you around. Nope, come on. Click on it. There we go. Alright. He's blind, is he? Well, that looks promising. That looks like a monocle. Look at it. It's the captain's monocle, so it is. Let's pick it up. Oh, I love it when things are this easy. I only need to reach into this hole, and oh, we know what's coming. Oh, damn. It's a little crab. Hey, buddy. It's a crab. A bloody crab. I should probably be doing this in an English accent now, shouldn't I? Whatever, it's too late. I've committed to it. Commit to it.
Haha, just you wait, crab. I've tamed the wild beast. Well done, shorty.
I'll call it Pinchy. Nice. We have a crab. Pinchy the Crab. That's a good name, don't you think? Alright, now we've got a monocle. Let's make that a dapper crab. Oh, come on. That's a gold idea. Whatever. Let's give him the monocle. Here's your monocle.
Thanks. I'll go to the castle in a bit and wait for you.
Alright. Got any burning barrels, signs, or torches you can bring? Dung forks would also work pretty well.
Ugh. I'll see if I can find something.
Alright. This revolution is moving right along. Let's take a look at that horizon. Looks quite nice. Very pretty.
Maybe we should gather a crew and set sail out on the distant islands instead of organizing a demonstration.
Yeah. But I always get seasick and throw up all over the place on ships.
Oh.
And then I'm grumpy all day because of the headache that usually causes.
You just need to get used to it, that's all.
Well, back to work. That was a nice break. The art is quite nice in this game. Alright.
Hey, yo. If I weren't so pissed drunk, I'd tell you to fuck off. But since I am totally pissed, I'll just say, hey, guys, want a drink on the house? Everything's on the house today, yay. Yeah, baby. Heck.
He is drunk as a skunk. What's over here? A bag with coffee beans. Let's get some of those, shall we? Curiosity killed the cat. No, pick up. Here we go. Got a handful of coffee beans. What's this? A coffee machine. How fortuitous. One of these new coffee machines. There's an unlit candle, and the water container is empty. There's no coffee powder in it, either. That sounds like a list of ingredients or things we need to do. Let's go pick up this. A glass. And this is a jar of honey. It's all sticky. Gross. I hate when honey gets all stuck to your fingers. Let's have a talk with this barman. A drunk barman would make a great addition to our little demonstration group. Yes, Cedric, nothing can go wrong with this plan. Oi! I'd like to order 12 big beers, please.
Oh, okay. Just a moment. No, wait, we don't want anything.
Okay, oh, big guy.
Oh, stop looking at me like that.
You shouldn't take advantage of his current state.
I just wanted to see if he would really do it. I can't help it. It's my researcher's spirit. So indignant.
Say, would you like to go on a demonstration with us?
Oh, sounds like fun. But I'm too pissed for that right now. If I weren't as pissed, I'd come. Hiccup.
Great. Well, we gotta sober this guy up if we want any hope of him joining our revolution. So let's do a few things right now. Use the crab on the beans. And it actually worked. We have coffee powder. That's a start. Now, what else did we need? We needed a fire. Well, we've got the matches. There's one other thing we need, and that's some water to make the coffee. Now, there was a barrel of water back in Victor's blacksmith, wasn't there? So let's go get some of that. Use the glass on the bucket of water. Right, now we have a glass of water. Now, what else do we need to do? Let's go back and sober that guy up. Come on, go to the harbor. There we go. And after that, I think I will cut the recording. Split this up a little bit. So, use the glass of water on the coffee machine. Fill the container with water. Use the coffee powder on the machine, and we'll use the matches on the machine. Now the candle is burning. Now, what else are we missing? Candle's burning. The water container is full. And there's coffee powder in the container. Okay, so we should be able to pick up use coffee machine? Use coffee machine? Use glass with coffee machine? There we go. Doo-doo-doo. There we go. We have a glass of coffee. We should really use a mug for that now, shouldn't we? Isn't the heat gonna conduct right through the glass? Here, drink this.
Oh, coffee. Thanks, magical little dwarf with a hat on.
Thanks.
No problem.
See you at the castle later, dwarfy.
Great. Well, it doesn't matter who he thinks we are. We've sobered him up. Oh, sorry. Okay. We have solved a great number of puzzles. But now it is time to take a quick break. So, we'll save here. And when we come back, we shall solve some more puzzles and get this revolution started right.